Giving a stage to students both in front of and behind the microphone in Arizona and beyond. Thank you for supporting the Varsity Sports Show, now the Varsity Media Foundation, a 501c3 educational organization.
KDUS AM 1060 Tempe Phoenix and KSLX HD2 Scottsdale Phoenix is brought to you by AC by J Heating, Cooling, Plumbing, and Drains.
This program is paid for by the Varsity Media Foundation, a 501c3 nonprofit educational organization, and its partners.
The Varsity Media Foundation presents the My Recruit Show with Coach Perot. And now, here's Coach Perot.
That's right, baby. The only game in town at 7 a.m. Mountain Standard Time, 10 a.m. on the East Coast. If you don't know, then they haven't told you yet. My partner, Vince Delicio, on the other side of the desk.
Good morning.
Our guy in the booth, rocking and rolling. And let me tell you right now, if you do not respect what we are bringing to the show, you don't have a heartbeat, baby, because we are the main player at the table. Vince, what do you say to that?
I'm excited, and we got a lot of good things going on. We're going to prove a lot of naysayers wrong, and we're doing that now, Coach.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. So. I'm going to tell you right now, there's going to be a lot of dinner talk come Thanksgiving, because when we make the announcement that we are planning on making, heads are going to be turning. They're going to be whispering, baby. Hey, enough of the chit chat. How about getting some scores?
It's time for Friday Night Lights.
All right, here we go. Thursday night football this week, a full pack schedule of Thursday night football. Couple games on Friday, Vince. We'll get to them. But on Thursday night, let's see what happened here. Great win by Millennium, 45-7 over Sunrise Mountain. How about that Cactus score? Cactus beats Desert Edge 20-14. Desert Edge, one of the most respected programs. The Carter brothers, one of the best set of head coaches you will find. That's a big win for Cactus.
Yeah.
Hat goes off to them. Paradise Valley, 28-24 over North Canyon.
Wow.
How about La Jolla grabbing a win, 32-23 over West Point? Good for them. Desert View, 41. Marana Mountain View, 19. Cienega with a 34-3 win over, looks like, Tucson.
Mm-hmm.
Ironwood Ridge drops one to Buena, 15-6. Is this score right?
What's that?
70-0. Marana beat Rincon. I don't even know.
Rincon, yeah.
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 Wow.
Yeah.
Maybe that's why they won 70-0. I haven't heard of them.
Yeah.
Sunnyside, huge win, 47-0 over Flowing Wells.
Yeah.
Let's see. We got Nogales, 42-21. Over Chola, big win, Verado over Casa Grande, 21-14.
Okay.
Campo Verde, huge win, 55-19 over Mesquite. ALO Queen Creek, 45-19 over Horizon. Boy, Horizon was rolling into that game.
Yeah, they were.
That's a big win for Queen Creek. Apollo, 35-14 over Ironwood. Willow Canyon, 47-23 over Goldwater. McKinnon, the Goldwater running back, looks like he just set the record for rushing yards. Congratulations to him. Big win for the Canyon View program, 48-0 over Agua Fria. We had a couple of we had a Canyon View player in Damari Colbert on the show last week, so congratulations to him and that program. Sunny Slope, 40-37 over Skyline. Notre Dame Prep continues to make their bid to try to get into the open with a 31-14 win over Gilbert. Desert Mountain hangs 61 on your boys over at Cactus Shadows.
Man. Wow.
In a 61-14 victory.
Yeah.
Maricopa, South Mountain. South Mountain won that one 27-21. Fairfax, big win, beats McClintock 22-18. Now, you were at the game I couldn't get to, which I wanted to, was Camelback Central.
What a game. Yeah, you know, you talk about the Phoenix Metro being back. A lot of great backstories. I mean, you got Carl Hayden turning things around with Coach Arenas. You got, you know, Central and Coach Hovick. You got Coach McNutt out of Camelback. Some great things happening. And that was a heck of a game. It was a heck of a game. You know, your quarterback, Dominic Bocci.
Coming on the show today.
Wow.
Yep. Yeah. Super, super excited. What did he do? Let's see. What has he done this year? I'm sorry. He's up for player of the year in my book.
He's a leader.
32 touchdowns, 3 interceptions, led that team to a 9-1 record. Come on, guys.
And his dad's a pretty cool guy, too.
He's coming on the show, too, today.
Wow, listen to that.
Well, yeah,
wow,
I power-packed this thing today.
I bet you do, man.
We ran into Coach Hovick, you and I. We called the Ottawa game.
Yes.
Live,
last week.
Ottawa versus Ottawa versus
Wayland Baptist.
Yeah, the Cowboys weren't happy with us. We were doing some controversial chit chat on the radio, but it was awesome. Up in the soundproof booth, Vince and I calling the game live on our YouTube.
Yeah,
that was super fun. Oh, help me out here, Aaron.
Yeah, sure,
Aaron. Where are we at on scores? Let me see.
You think Aaron has scores?
Yeah, he's going to help me out here. Okay. Let me see here. Who's
come on.
There we go.
Oh, I knew it was I knew you would bring it back.
There we go.
Yeah. Nothing better on a Saturday morning.
Oh, baby, nothing better than the Liberty Lions. The Liberty Lions are now ranked in the top 25 in the country, Vince.
Wow.
The Liberty Lions are now ranked top 25 in the country with a 37-7 win over Boulder Creek. And I hate to say this.
Yeah.
And I don't want to
sound
disrespectful.
But you're going to say it anyway, aren't you? Yeah.
Congratulations to Boulder Creek for getting 7 points in that game. Okay. That's how good that defense is, Vince. I mean, 37-7, that's a very conservative game for them.
Yes, it is.
Williams Field drops a tough one to Higley, 31-21. Queen Creek, in typical Queen Creek ground-and-pound tough defense fashion, 12-6 win over Sal Point. Big win for Red Mountain, 21-14 over Mesa Mountain View. Okay. I was at the Happy Valley battle, the Battle of Happy Valley, they call it.
Yeah.
O'Connor versus Mountain Ridge. Mountain Ridge has not beaten O'Connor in 6 straight years. I ran into Brian Cole and QT. The utmost confidence coming from him right now.
You give him some suggestions?
No, I don't have to. That man, I think he's one of the most underrated head coaches in high school football.
He's a nice guy, too. He'll stop and talk to you. He stopped to talk to you at QT. He was probably in a hurry.
That O'Connor team is extremely dangerous.
Yeah.
Because they can control the clock. They run the ball better than anybody I've seen. And when they have to throw the ball, Ben Currents, listen to what I am saying, is the most underrated wide receiver in the country. This is a hurdler. This is a champion hurdler who is all of 6'2". He runs like a deer. 2 ridiculous touchdowns, should have been 3. I mean, O'Connor, and we're going to get into open talks, but it looks like O'Connor's in the open.
No.
Yes. At the 7 seed is what it looks like.
Wow, you talk about
so
a rebound.
You might see an O'Connor Basha first round. And let me tell you something. Look, I know all those top teams, but Coach Cole can control the clock.
Yes, he can.
He's got a great defense. We're bringing on one of the best DBs in the state today, Jackson Barton, who is the cornerback for O'Connor.
Yeah.
Geez, it's going to be interesting. Let's run down a quick couple more scores. Dobson 15-11 over Trevor Brown.
Okay.
Mesa beats Cibola 49-14. Another Westwood shootout. North just gets the edge, 57 to 48. Chaparral drops a tough one. Highland making their bid for the Open. Highland wins that one, 42-14.
Yeah.
Boy, every time you say something about Centennial, they just turn the gas up. Centennial beats Pinnacle 45-15. That is a convincing statement game for Centennial.
Yeah.
I mean, that is a, if you don't think we're back game, it's exactly what that was. Basha, you know, in cruise control right now, 52-7 over Perry. Here's one that I did not expect. Castile pulls out the upset over Jake Borrow.
I'm looking right
and
at
I
that
score. And I
shouldn't
say upset. Because I've been telling you how good Castile is.
Yeah.
31-14 over Corona del Sol. That pretty much solidified. Corona is out of the Open.
Yeah.
Looks like Coach Borrow is probably going to get a 1 or 2 seed, which is fine. I know Coach Borrow. He's completely okay with getting a 1 or 2 seed in the playoffs. And Connor Ackerley dropping this thing into fifth gear and going for it. Chandler drops the battle. What is that street called over there?
Arizona Avenue.
Arizona Avenue, yeah. Battle. Hamilton kicks a field goal with no time left on the clock for a 19-17. I can tell you right now, if I was in Vegas, I would have bet $1 million on Chandler in that game.
Yeah.
So that shakes some things up. And then last one, Valley Vista in the playoffs with a 31-21 win over Shadow Ridge. Now, in the last couple minutes, Open talks.
Okay.
Arizona Open talks look like you know who at number one.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So Liberty gets the one. I think Basha 2.
Okay.
Probably Chandler 3.
Even with the loss?
Yeah. Chandler 3, I think Hamilton 4.
Really?
Saguaro 5.
Oh.
And I'm just spitballing here.
Yeah.
I'm not as Jacob Salig is the best at this stuff. Let me see if we can go to Gridiron or Jacob Saliga's Twitter.
Yeah.
And see. Let me see what Gridiron has as a Chris Eaton is usually spot on with this thing. He has Liberty 1. Where is it, Chris? Come on. I know it's in there.
And you still got, you know, in the conversation, you still have Centennial.
Centennial's going to be probably locked in at the 6th seed.
Okay. What about Highland?
And then Highland's going to get the 8 is what it looks like.
Highland will get the 8.
So from the bottom up, Highland, O'Connor, Centennial, Saguaro, and then the big 5 out up at the King of the Hill there.
Yeah.
So, and you know, that makes for a...
So Notre Dame Prep, ALA Queen Creek, like, they get shut out of this?
It looks like they're going to be out due to the points. And
yeah.
I don't know this, but I'm going off of what the experts say, and I think these guys do an amazing job. Let me see if Salig has got it posted.
Yeah. Yeah.
Here it is. Liberty, Basha, Hamilton, Chandler, Saguaro, Centennial, O'Connor, Highland.
Yeah.
That win over Mountain Ridge gives them more points than Highland's win over Chaparral, Jacob said. So that puts O'Connor at 7.
Yeah. Last night, Saguaro had a real tight win over Brophy. Brophy's, they're the best 3-7 team in the country.
Yeah, Brophy, and they're going to be in the playoffs causing havoc. So
yeah.
That's what looks like the Open. College Coaches Corner is coming up with a good friend of mine. Let's take it from there.
Okay.
Go hear from some sponsors, and we'll be back.
Games Out West featuring Ryan Brooks brings NFL, NBA, and local sports talk to you Monday nights at 7 here on KTUS AM 1060 and KTUS1060.com.
Hey there, this is Coach Mike Famigliotti, wide receivers coach and special teams coordinator for the Minot State University Beavers football team, and you're listening to the My Recruit Show with Coach Lou Perrone.
Education Solutions is your one-stop shop for test prep, tutoring, and virtual courses. Need help on a subject? Prepping for the ACT or SAT? Need to take an online course?
Let the experienced patient faculty of Education Solutions help your student achieve success. All classes are NCAA approved and accredited. Call 205-960-6444 or go to youredsolutions.com. Education Solutions. Hey guys, Vince here to talk about Angel Dentistry. It's where my wife and I have gone for over 10 years, and we trust them with our routine and extensive dental care because they care. Dr. Amber Angel is an Arizona native, born in the town of Miami, and has been practicing in the Valley over 20 years. For general to comprehensive dental services, call 602-788-2008. Located off of Cave Creek Road, just north of the 101 in North Phoenix, Angel Dentistry, proud supporters of our young people and proud partners of the Varsity Sports Show.
Carving out time in your afternoon for the Doug Gottlieb Show right here on KDUS AM 1060, 100.7 HD2, and KDUS1060.com. Weekdays from 1 to 3 p.m.
This is the My Recruits College Coaches Corner.
Vince stepped out to get me a quick drink of water. Coming back, college coaches segment. Last week we did a lot of extra recruiting spotlights, but I wanted to get back on track and talk about college coaches, talk about their programs, talk about what they bring to our platform here at My Recruits and the My Recruit Show. Great guest, because I'll tell you what the importance of this guest is. Joining me on the phone right now is defensive coordinator for Buena Vista University in Storm Lake, Iowa, Mr. Jake Mandelko. Coach Mandelko, are you there, sir?
I'm here this morning. How are we doing, Coach Lou?
Awesome. Thank you so much for joining us. You on the bus?
Yep, we're on the bus on the way to game 10.
All right. Tell us who you're playing and what the outlook is for this one.
All right. Well, we're on our way to play Simpson College. And, last game of the season for both schools, and neither of them, we're both on the outside of the playoff picture. So right now we're just playing to send ourselves off into the offseason with a win and good momentum into recruiting. The way it's looking, I think, I know I can speak for us, and I think it's kind of them too, but I mean, maybe I think a lot of programs, we're a little bit behind, we're banged up going into the last game here, but. I think it's going to be a game that, both teams, we kind of know each other and what we want to do. It's going to come down to a lot of execution and who's going to want to play harder. It's a little bit chilly up here this morning.
What is chilly? Tell us here in Arizona what chilly is.
All right. Well, chilly is, I think our kickoff temp is right around 30 degrees this morning. It'll warm up a little bit more than that as the game goes on. But we joked around with our guys from Houston and our guys from the Phoenix area that, like, hey, it's going to be cold, but they're playing in the cold too. And really, we've been fortunate this year. We haven't had a game in the 30s yet. I think our coldest game so far this year has been in the 50s. So, we kind of got slapped with winter here this last week of the season. But, we practiced through it all week and looking forward to, like I said, end of the season. On a positive note.
Yeah, Simpson, a good friend of the program too, Coach Matt Jeter over there and Coach Hoffman, the OC. So, we've all hung out together, and when you guys come into town, we hang out at my house. And so we've all kind of sat down and had great conversations about it. We got Henry Fields calling. Henry Fields, hold on. We're going to shut the phone off here and finish talking to Coach Mandelko. Coach, so you were a four-year safety. You were a four-year safety for Nebraska Kearney, okay? Four-year safety there. You got the GA job at Nebraska Lincoln from 11 to 2014. Got the defensive coordinator position at Hastings. And then this is now your fifth season as the DC at Buena Vista. Is that true?
Yes, yeah. So fifth season, 6 years. We had that weird D3 shut all the way down for COVID. So been here at BV the 2017 season was my first season here.
My first college coaching job was coaching tight ends O-line at Buena Vista College in Storm Lake, Iowa in 1994.
Really?
Yes, it was BVC back then. BVC, home of the Beavers in Storm Lake. And,
I did not know that.
Yeah, I lived in the athletic director's, had this house. It was a, he was a rebuild. He was going to rent it out. I lived in the basement, and I paid him $100 a month rent and no running water. And what I did is it, when it started getting cold, Coach, you can appreciate this. When it started getting cold, I was 22 years old. I didn't know any better. I pulled the mattress into the kitchen of this, the basement of this little, you know, apartment. And, you know, I was stupid. Lit the pilot light of the oven. And that's how I slept at night. And he asked me, he pulled me into his office. Look, there's no electric bill. What's going on? But the gas bill is extremely high. And I said, well, this is what I'm doing. He said, you idiot. Anyway. That was it.
So,
Doc Eglund, Roger Eglund, is he still alive? He was the AD.
Not. Who's the AD now, Coach? Who's the AD now?
Our
Kevin Twaite was the head coach. You know Kevin Twaite?
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I do know the name. I
yeah, he's at
name.
Iowa Central now. He's the AD at Iowa Central.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, so, we've had several ADs since then, but Scott Brown is our athletic director now.
Okay.
Enough with the Vince reminiscing living in the basement. No,
okay.
That's awesome, Vince. That's a great, great story.
Yeah.
So another great story.
Small world stuff.
Yeah, another great story, what a lot of people do not know. The My Recruits baby was born in 2018.
Okay.
Okay, going on. Deep into year four right now. The first, very first football coach that recruited a My Recruits player is on the line with us right now.
No kidding.
Absolutely.
Wow.
Is that the truth, Coach?
Yes, that is. And our relationship, started. And all of a sudden, I guess meeting you. And then I knew you as Coach Lou before I knew you were my recruit.
That's right. That's
I bet he's got some stories.
Yeah,
huh?
We started working together. The first young man that we worked on, his name was Jimmy Richardson. He was a cornerback out of Verado.
Okay.
And we didn't get him over there, but long story short, we circled the wagon back, and Coach had seen Jimmy Richardson again when he played for the Maricopa Mustangs and Doug Mendoski. And, you know, we've just been good friends ever since. I have several players on the roster that are successful right now, right, Coach?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. A couple guys, they're some of the ones that wish they wouldn't have gotten hit by the injury bug, because we'd probably be a little bit hotter than what we are right now. But that's all part of it.
I've been responsible for putting a key piece of the offense in place.
Man.
Cool. Without a doubt.
Wow. Call some plays, too?
Yeah, no, not at all. They do a great look. Tell us about Storm Lake, Iowa.
So Storm Lake is, it's a nice-sized community, but it's significantly smaller than the Phoenix area, but we're about somewhere between 10,000 and 15,000 people.
It's grown.
It's right on the shores of Storm Lake. I mean, it's a beautiful campus setting and beautiful setting, for small college football. I mean, shoot, our stadium overlooks the lake, so I mean that's a real, real cool setup.
Yeah, but it's beautiful when I see the pictures.
Yeah, it really is. It really is. And then the community itself is a really big. It's kind of a melting pot of a community. We've got two Titan plants in our community that really has allowed for us to, and it helped us in recruiting. We focus a lot on the Houston area, and then the Phoenix area.
How old is the town, Coach, itself?
Oh, geez. The community itself is.
Yeah.
I mean, the college has been around since, I believe, the 1880s.
Yeah.
I mean, the community is a little bit older than that, probably 1870s.
Yeah, you got, it's like Cocoon. You got original owners that live on the street that I lived on. They used to push me out of the snow when my truck would get stuck, and then they'd go back into their houses. Anyway.
Coach, how much snow do you guys get there?
Oh, shoot.
An inch or two a season?
Oh, more than that. We probably get the total of accumulation, over a winter. We're probably looking at, a little over a foot.
Yeah. Oh, that's not too bad. I used to get
It was like negative 10 over Thanksgiving.
To Coach Bakken, good friend of the program up there at Concordia Moorhead. I think he said, like, they get a foot a week.
Yeah. But you fully can't appreciate it unless you've been there. I mean, Storm Lake is a beautiful setting. It was hot in the summer, I remember. In the fall, beautiful, leaves turn brown. And it does, and it snows. It snows, but it's a beautiful community.
I miss the fall. We only have, what, summer and spring down here.
So we have spring?
Yeah, well, that's winter.
Yeah.
Coach, tell us what you look for. Tell us what you're looking for in a recruit.
You know what we're looking for. I mean, obviously, talent is you know, a huge thing. I think that goes for everything. But when we focus on our recruiting, we look for what we call our three core values, and we want guys that are accountable. You know, accountability. Not only you know when it comes to football things, that's usually easy when a kid wants to play football. He'll show up to practice. He'll show up to you know and on time and early, and he'll do what he's supposed to do football wise when it comes to you know, lifting and workouts and things like that. But we want guys that are going to be accountable in the classroom as well. You know, handle their classroom work, show up, turn their stuff in. You know, we say do what you're supposed to do when you're supposed to do it at the level that it's supposed to be done. We look for accountability. We look for guys that are engaged. And that's with guys, you know, amongst their teammates. Get to know your teammates, you know, so you can build that trust, that relationship. You know, it's not realistic that you're going to have, you know, 90 to 100 best friends on a roster, but at least engage with your teammates so they can get to know you, you can get to know them, and it's still build a trust. You don't have to be a best friend to have trust amongst, you know, a defense and offense or just, you know, amongst your teammates. So it's guys that are engaged and engaged in the classroom and around campus, too. We really encourage our guys to get involved in one other thing around campus, at least one other thing around campus outside of football, whether it's a faith-based organization or some sort of, you know, club group or organization that has to do with, you know, their major or field of study or something else that interests them. Maybe it's just, you know, outdoor rec or fishing, you know, something to do with fishing or hunting or, you know, something along those lines. And then the final thing we look for is guys that are going to put the team before themselves and realize that doing, you know, what's needed for the team is going to allow for the team to be successful. And therefore, you know, if you have a successful team, you're going to get some individual success as well. You know, wins way more are, you know, way outweigh the, you know, I led the conference in tackles, but yeah, but we were on defense, you know, 95 snaps a game. Maybe we could have, you know, focus more on fitting a role to allow us to be more successful on defense, get off the field, get our offense the ball, and you know, win 7, 8, 9 games rather than struggle. But, you know, I got my tackle. You know, so we want guys that are focused on the good of the team rather than focus on sole individual, you know, recognition.
For the recruits that are listening, at BVU, Coach Delk, you heard it here. Recruiting quality young men, young athletes that want to be part of a family and make a difference. Hashtag defend the lake. Coach, good luck against Simpson. I know you guys are going to put your best foot forward. I can't wait till you come down in a couple weeks. We will definitely get together. Jake Mandelko, defensive coordinator, Buena Vista University. Vince, a great guest, Coach. Thank you.
Go Beavs.
Go Beavers.
SB Nation Radio is now Sports Map Radio, keeping sports content fresh and fun. Join us right here on KDUS AM 1060.
This is Jeff Bowen, football coach for the ACU Firestorm. You're listening to the My Recruit Show with Coach Perrone.
A&S Window Cleaning has been serving the Valley since 2003. Richard Bryan and their staff provide the cleanest, punctual, and most professional service in the Valley. But they don't only do windows, they can pressure wash your house and hardscapes as well. Need sunscreens? A&S Window Cleaning has been a dealer and installer of the highest quality sunscreens in the country for 15 years. So give Richard and Brian a call at 602-290-8400. Founder-level sponsors, the Kristen Graziano Group with HomeSmart Elite, are proud to be Saguaro alumni, community advocates, and your hometown realtors. The Kristen Graziano Group is ranked in the top 1.5% of real estate teams nationally and your top-selling team right here in Sabercat territory. The Kristen Graziano Group can currently be seen on the Emmy-nominated TV show Selling the Valley of the Sun. When you're ready to buy, sell, or want to know the value of your home, reach out to the group that knows the neighborhood, the Kristen Graziano Group.
Monday nights from 7 to 8 p.m., it's James Out West featuring Ryan Brooks as the duo breaks down the NFL, NBA, and the local sports scene here on KDUS AM 1060.
It's the My Recruits Chalk Talk.
All right, we've got a lot to pack into this show here. So we're going to do Chalk Talk segment. We're going to bring on Dave Bogchi from Team Impact. Very excited about that. But I wanted to squeeze in this Chalk Talk segment, a very, very special player, like I told you, Vince. Jackson Barton, 6'1", 180-pound corner for Sandra Day O'Connor High School. Jackson, are you there?
Yeah.
A man.
Well, come on, coach. It's after 7 a.m., for God's sakes.
A man
Saturday,
of many words. Are you kidding me? 7 a.m. This guy probably ran 2 miles already. Yeah. This guy is a natural athlete, Vince. If you have not seen the film on him, special player. Jackson, thanks for joining us this morning.
No problem, coach.
Ranked a 3-star by 24/7 Sports.
Okay.
Underclassman of the year. Currently holds a scholarship offer to Northern Arizona, 3.4 GPA, multi-sport athlete, track and field. I mean, Jackson, you got quite a resume. Tell us about how this season's going. You guys are going to be in the open, huh? Big stage?
I know.
Is that the way it looks right now?
It looks like we're going to be in the open.
Tell us about, this is what I want to ask you, because I know you're such a man of many words.
Yeah.
Tell us about what you personally feel like you've accomplished this season.
I feel like we've accomplished a lot during this whole season because we've had games where we played terrible games and then we always bounce back. And you've seen us compete with open teams like Centennial. Game was really close.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I was at the games. Centennial game and it was lockdown central. You know, I spoke to you last week. And, you know, we spoke about how boring it gets on your side of the field, right? Because, Vince, they don't throw the ball to him at all.
Never. Why not?
Why not? He's the best corner. He's arguably the best cornerback in the state of
Arizona.
Oh,
I thought you meant, defensively. Yeah, and so the defense. I was wondering. I was like, is he playing offense or not throwing the ball to him?
They don't throw the ball to him. I mean, they challenged him this week, and he made – two amazing plays. Yeah. Did you even let up a pass against Mountain Ridge?
No, I did not.
Yeah.
Okay. Do they, Jackson, when you go into a week's game, does coach specifically tell you you will be matched up against their best receiver, or do you play a side, and whoever's on your side, that's who you're covering?
I get matched up with their best receiver. So if we go into man and the receiver's a slot, safety will go to corner and I'll go to slot so I can cover him.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Coach Bolus, I told you, Coach Bolus, one of the best defensive coordinators.
Yeah.
And Jackson will definitely testify to that. Coach Bolus is one of the best DCs in the state, possibly in the country. Knows how to utilize his talent. And when you have a lockdown corner, you lock down the best receiver, and that's it. That's the way it should be.
Wow.
Too many of these guys, like you said, Vince, play aside.
Yeah, play aside.
Not here.
Yeah.
Jackson will go wherever. If you putting your best receiver out there, you're going to know this guy's going to be on him.
Yeah, but what does it do for the rest of the defense? What if there's a weakness of the guy next to him and Jackson's on, have they put him on the other side?
Luckily, O'Connor doesn't have many holes in that defense.
Okay.
So we can't answer that. But tell us about how exciting it was to get the NAU offer.
It was very exciting. I remember they came when they came and told me that I got my offer. The first thing I did was call my mom.
Yeah,
really exciting.
She must have been excited too. So we've got a lot of action right now. We're here. We're going to wrap up, but you know, University of Hawaii is currently recruiting him. Utah Tech, Southern Utah.
Yeah.
Who else, Jackson? Help me out. I know there's a bunch of
Utah Tech is D1 now.
Yeah. Who is that?
Fresno State.
Oh, Fresno State. I love that school. Yeah.
San Jose State reached out to me. Yeah. We're even talking to Cal.
Cal.
Yeah, Coach McClure. You know, they passed Jackson through the pipeline, and I think you're going to see this camp season.
Yeah.
He's going to explode.
Wow.
You know, I remember saying this with Alex Deuce from Mountain Ridge when he had one or two offers. I said, watch, he's going to explode. Everybody's going to come through, and it's just going to be offer, 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 offer. Young man that's very grounded, doesn't need 20,000 offers, wants the right fit.
Right.
Coach Partridge over at Northern Arizona says, hey, we can close recruiting now. We'll take him. But expect big things out of this young man. Watch him closely. Jackson, what is your Twitter?
Jackson_Barton6
Yeah.
You can reach out to me. You can check him out on the myrecruits.org website. Jackson Barton, arguably the best 2024 cornerback in the country. Thank you for joining Vince and I on the My Recruit Show.
No problem, guys. Have a great day.
See you, Jackson.
Let's go right into Dave Bogchy. Is he here? Is he ready to go? Let's go. Mr. Bogchy, Coach, are you there?
I am. What's going on?
Nice. Wow. Go ahead, Vince. Take it away.
I don't know what to say. This guy is just greatness. He just oozes greatness. I saw him last night, and he had people following him, in front of him, sweeping the floor before he stepped on it.
Yeah.
And
special
behind
guy.
Him. Yeah. Yeah. This guy is something else. He's doing selfies with everyone. Yeah.
Yeah. Special guy. Dave, tell us about the Team Impact program and what it actually is.
Well, first of all, Barton's one of ours.
That's right. He's a Team Impact guy.
Oh.
He was with us for 3 years. He's a great young man.
Yep. And you've had, Dave, you've had a ton of these great athletes are yours.
I mean, I honestly shouldn't say mine, but they're like the
yours as part of the program, I mean.
Exactly. Yeah. No, it is. And, you know, we've never recruited. And, you know, I think it seems like a failed, doomed kind of model, but it works because we don't have any bad coaches and there's no agendas, and it really makes people uncomfortable, but it gives hope to a lot of these kids, and then the ones that put the work in, they kind of come out and get your Jackson Bartons and your Christian Camaradas and your, you know, Dominics and your Izzy Fathers and all these types of players. So it's great.
Tell us about what Team Impact actually does. I mean, it's so many. It wears so many hats, but when you founded this program, what was your intention?
Yeah, when I started Team Impact in 2013, the intention was to try to build a program that would provide parents a roadmap that would take youth athletes from a young age all the way into high school to where they could go to high school and have a really significant potential opportunity to start right away and be a contributor and have a great high school experience. Like, I think the thing that doesn't get talked about a lot is kids want to play. Like, all this recruiting and all this stuff, like, kids want to play. Like, it's the worst thing in the world to put all this work in, go to some high school, and you never play.
Yeah.
You never even get a chance to do it. You can be the old man at the bar showing off the state championship ring, and you can even play. Like, how embarrassing and pathetic is that, right? Like you want to play.
Coach, what's interesting?
Let's give these guys a chance to play by teaching them how to work hard and learn fundamentals and have knowledge and have ability. And then, you know, it's up to the coaches to give them those opportunities, but at least get them prepared. You know, and it wasn't until I met you, Lou, that I realized that we could actually take this farther and add, something beyond high school.
Yeah.
You know what's interesting about you, Coach, last night? I'm sure there's many interesting things about you. But one thing that I found in talking to you the last couple of days, because I saw you first at Central on Thursday, and then I saw you last night for the Saguaro Brophy in the same spot. I told you I'd camped there from the night before because I didn't want to lose my seat. But but what's interesting about you is you always talk about, at least in the conversations I've had, leadership. It's never about, you know, the getting 4 stars, 5 stars. You're always talking about developing leaders in kids.
Well, absolutely. It's all that matters. So the genesis of Team Impact was this. My mom was an autistic school teacher for 35 years. She's my hero. And she thinks I'm a fiery guy. She's something else. But at the end of the day, like, I look around society. I look at, you know, boys being stripped of their masculinity as they're growing up. I look at, you know, the world that we're leaving our kids with. And I was like, look, I really want to have an impact on this. I really want to see what I can do to help the world around my son and my children. My children are going to be fine. You know, it's like, they're going to be fine. They're going to walk with 3 foot long, you know what, and they're going to be fine. But how do I make sure that they're not surrounded by a bunch of sheep? And so my whole intent was, like, there's only one thing I know how to coach and teach, which is football. So impact is nothing but a skin for my mission to want to improve the world. And I can only do it within my own bubble, and I can only do it one person at a time. So I do what I can within the bubble I'm in, and, you know, and my whole goal is to raise good people that are going to be leaders of society, and I'm selfish and want to, you know, have an alpha mindset or whatever, a confident mindset. I shouldn't even say alpha, just a confident mindset, and go out in the world and do great things. And boy, girl, short, fat, ugly, skinny, handsome, yellow, brown, black, red, rich, poor, doesn't matter. None of that stuff matters. It's all BS.
Quarterback.
All that matters is go do you. Go be the greatest you that you can be.
So well said, Coach. You know, quarterback at Notre Dame Prep calls me up, says, listen, I don't like what's going on here. I don't think it's the right spot for Dominic. What do you think we send a 4.4, just, you know, 5'10", young Indian quarterback? And I pulled Central out of the air. I said, Hovick's a great guy. They get surrounded by athletes. They need a leader. And let me tell you something. The best thing that happened to that program and the best thing that happened to that young man was making that match. And that's where I go the extra mile sometimes. I mean, what kind of experience has Central been to you guys?
I mean, brother, when you tell that story, it's emotional. That night, I cried. I remember calling you. I cried. I was crying. I cried like 5 times in my last 25 years, and that was one of them. And, you know, we love Notre Dame, but there's nothing about that. There was a situation that I was, you know, writing on the wall kind of thing. But, you know, the experience at Central, it's not just about what Dominic's been able to do for the program. It's about what the program's done for us. Central has taught my son so much. I mean, he wasn't even there 4 months and was at 2 funerals of players that he knew. And I'll tell you, it's so deep that, you know, Coach Matt Allen was more emotional this week than I was, that it could potentially have been Dom's last game. And, you know, basically told me that Dom filled a hole in his heart from Corvell Simmons passing away because of his adopted son who drowned.
Yeah.
So like this stuff is way bigger. This is the greatest story in Arizona high school. The great, I've been saying it for 6 months and nobody wants to listen, but this is the greatest story in Arizona high school. Nothing else has been compared. And if you it is Foz, you know, Quentin Conlin, all these kids, it's unreal. It's unreal. And when Izzy was on the track crying at the end of that game, this is a young man last year that missed a 24-yard field goal that would have put Camelback away and sent his recent champ. So he's living that through. And now he's seeing the emotion of being one of the guys on the field making a play at the end of the game to win that game, and the defense stepping up. And he's just overwhelmed in emotion, you know. And 2 years ago, this young man's in, you know, I think it was Tamundi, Africa, you know. So they speak 6 languages. So Dominic's learned more, gotten more out of Central than probably Central's even gotten out of him. Like, it's just been an amazing synergy. It's been, you know, there's probably a better word for that, but there's just, you know, and I've learned. And now, you know, I work with, like, look, last year, I come in, I got, you know, I'm your typical sports dad. You know, my kid, my, you know, we're going to do this. I sit down in the stands, and Central's got a center last year. This young man was 158 pounds. Varsity center, 158 pounds. His dad's in the stands, nicest gentleman I ever met. His name is Ray. I can't remember who it was. I would sit with him in the stands. He knew every player's name. He's chanting for every player while his son is getting hogwashed out there.
Yeah.
Okay. And I'm sitting there like, this gentleman is watching his son get destroyed. His son is playing the most unselfish position on the field, the most important position on the field. and is not complaining one bit.
Well,
and
Dave, you talk about you
learn to bite my tongue.
You talk about unselfishness. You talk about unselfishness, and let me tell you something right now. Unselfishness to me is the epitome of what you bring to the table in that Team Impact program. For everybody that's listening, if you have a young athlete, there's many options for you in this Team Impact program. There's different levels. We are starting, you're starting something that's going to be huge for the youth. So flag football, mentorship, leadership, training, some of the best coaches. Everybody, if you're looking to get your young athletes somewhere, Dave Bogchi, 480-246-9462. Look up Team Impact. You can reach us. Dave, thank you so much for joining Vince and I this morning.
Absolutely. I just want to throw one thing out. Sunday, November 27th, Central High School, 6 to 8 p.m., we got a free open 7-on-7 clinic. Open anybody 9 years old through high school varsity.
You heard it there. We'll also talk about it more on the show. Send us the details, Dave.
All right. Thank you so much, gentlemen.
See you, Coach.
I'll turn those picks into gold.
Wall-to-wall NFL coverage and the biggest stories coming to you from 3 to 5 p.m. The Rich Eisen Show here on KDUS AM 1060 and KDUS1060.com.
This is Jake Irie, defensive line coach at Northern State University, and you're listening to the My Recruits Show with Coach Perrone.
Chris Scott of RE/MAX is Central Oregon's best realtor for anyone thinking of a vacation home or relocation. He's our very own born and raised Venetian who moved his family to Central Oregon nearly 15 years ago. Contact Chris if you're thinking of exploring beautiful Central Oregon. It truly is living at its best. 541-999-5614. Proud partner of the Varsity Sports Shows, it's Dylan.
Hey, this is Coach Perrone. I want to thank you for listening and tuning in to the My Recruit Show. It's been a long time coming, but we're so proud to be able to bring you football and recruiting talk from around the United States. Recruiting's been a passion of mine for a long time, and I am thankful to share it with you.
Gottlieb Show, Monday through Friday, 1 to 3 p.m. right here on KDUS AM 1060.
It's the My Recruits Recruiting Spotlight.
All right, let's do a quick welcome to the family. Clarence Tucker, 2026, out of Mountain Point High School. Brody Hinks, 2026. This kid's going to be a stud. Mark my words. 2026, all-around superstar. Defensive lineman, defensive end out of Mountain Ridge. Who else? Let's see. That's it. Welcome to the family, Brody Hinks and Clarence Tucker. On the line with us is a special, special athlete out of California, Jaden Moss. Jaden, are you there? Jaden Moss, welcome to the show. Good morning. How are you?
Coach, it's an hour earlier there.
I'm good. How are you?
Good. What? Rise and shine, buddy. I'm sorry we got you up so early, but I want everybody to know who you are, what you are, how special you are. A 2024, Vince,
yeah.
Currently a three-star running back slash wide receiver athlete at Etiwanda High School.
Oh, yeah.
5'8", 170 pounds, 168, has a 3.3 GPA, was the 2022 ESPN Elite Camp Running Back MVP.
Wow.
For those of you that don't know, when they say Elite Camp, the best of the best of the best in the country are at that camp. This young man was the MVP of that. Currently holds an offer from Purdue, but you haven't seen anything yet. Tell us about how this season's going, Jaden.
It's going pretty good. We made it to the semifinals in the playoffs, the D5 playoffs. It's going pretty good.
All right. Tell us what college coaches should know about you.
they should know that I'm a determined player, that I work hard. That's like, I feel like that's the best thing about me. I put in the work every day, like be where I'm at.
Yeah, one of the hardest workers on and off the field. His dad, fantastic coach, Coach Moss. One of the things that he talks about, doesn't say my son's the fastest, which he is. Doesn't say my son's the twitchiest, which he is. He says my son is the hardest worker I've ever seen. And I've heard that from other coaches. I've heard that from other players, that this young man's work ethic is second to none. Jaden, what is your Twitter?
My Twitter is JadenMoss_1.
You are going to explode at camps this year. Tell us about some of the programs that are actively recruiting you outside of the obvious ones in the Pac-12.
Central Michigan. We went up there not too long ago. I kind of liked it up there. It was cool.
Central Michigan. Central. Yep, I know. Yeah. University of California, Arizona, and Arizona State. Great conversation with Coach Ball, the head coach at NAU, about you. You fit a lot of what the Pac-12 does with that running back athlete spot. I'm so excited that you're part of our family. I know you're going to have an amazing offseason. When I say amazing offseason, Vince, you're going to see this guy all over
yeah.
Twitter. Jaden, I know you're super tired. Vince, anything else?
Well, no, I'm looking at their schedule. I mean, you know, the Inland Empire used to live in Chino Hills. The Inland Empire is some good football, and they hung 69 last night on Canyon High School. I mean, that's no slump. That's no slouch. And you got Losinger out of Lawndale, so you guys are going, that's a neutral site. Where's that game going to be played? Do you know yet?
It's going to be at Edowanda.
At Edowanda? Oh, so at your place. Yeah. Okay, because it says neutral playoff game, but wow.
Prediction.
Yeah.
200 yards of all-purpose yards for Mr. Jaden Moss.
Hang another 50 on him. Yeah.
I'll tell you what. Jaden, one of the most special players we have in our platform, thank you for joining us. I know you're probably on your way to film. Good luck the rest of the way. I can't wait to see you in the offseason, bud.
All right, thank you.
Special, special, special athlete. I'm telling you.
Where do you find these guys?
I got lucky getting this young man. He's going to be he's a three-star, but they're way off. I'm telling you. This kid has 4.48 speed, twitchy, extremely hard worker. Watch out for Jaden Moss. We have Dominic Baggi on the line. Let's rock and roll. Go right into a contestant for Arizona Player of the Year. Dom, are you there? Dom.
Coach, how are you?
Wake up, buddy. It's game time. 2023 quarterback from the Central High School. 4.3 GPA.
Come on.
Arguably, probably going to be valedictorian.
Wow.
Dom's just about 5'10", 170. An all-region, all-district, all-academic Ed Daugherty guy, too.
Wow.
Yeah. Was on the Ed Daugherty nomination, National Honor Society. I mean, this kid's resume goes on and on and on and on. Tell us about what recently happened, Dom. Vince doesn't know.
What happened?
Your dad had called me, and I was so excited. Tell us about, if you know what I'm talking about, something happened this week that was pretty awesome.
Yeah, so this week I got a call from my congressional nomination representative that I got the nomination for the Service Academy. So that was a super good blessing. And
Army and Navy nomination.
Both. Wow.
In the middle of the election, he called.
Wow. Now, which guy was it? Because actually your dad told me about this. Was it David Schweikert?
Yes, it was.
Congressman Schweikert. He's in our district.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, in the middle of the election.
Wow.
That, you know, this young man has achieved so much. Larry Kinbaum, who I respect in the coaching community more than anybody at Washington University St. Louis, says, I don't know if we're going to get this guy over Navy and over Army, but let me tell you something. He's about as special comes. When you talk about overall athlete, overall person, this is the guy. Tell us about the amazing season you guys have had.
Yeah, so we've had gone 9-1 and won the region and made the playoffs for the first time since like 2006, which is a really long time, but it was really a testament to the hard work of all the coaches and players this year. We worked our butts off in the off season, and then it all came to fruition during the regular season. So it was a very great experience.
I saw these guys, and Dominic, we had this conversation post-game the other night. I saw them at camp up at Camp Shadow Pines in July, and they weren't even thinking about playoffs at that point. Not that they didn't think they were good enough, but they were so, you know, focused on trying to get through conditioning when I'm there trying to interview them, and they're huffing and puffing. But to see where you've gone, and, you know, you're a great, great young man. I'm 5'7". Would you say that you and I stood eye to eye?
He's about 5'9" and a half.
Okay. Whatever.
He wears really, really short cleats.
Okay.
So, but you know what? I'll tell you what. He's got the heart of a 6'6".
Oh, hands down. If Kyler Murray can do it, you know.
He reminds me a lot of Kyler Murray.
Yeah.
Dominic has one of the quickest releases, has great velocity on his throws. Look, at the end of the day, this is a kid that's just, no matter what he does, I don't care if he doesn't play football, is going to have the most success out of everything he does in life because of how he holds himself and who he is. Dom, what was it like coming into an inner city program, you know, as a young Indian athlete and stepping in and having to be the leader? How did you get this team to rally behind you?
Yeah, it was an interesting experience. It definitely helped shape who I am and helped shape me into the leader I would become. But, like, I definitely wouldn't be the same person without it. It was definitely very hard. It was definitely took a lot of, like, time to build those relationships.
Mm-hmm.
But at the end of the day, like, I believe our team is based off of love and, like, because everyone's so close and we've all played together, gotten really close the last 3 years, that it really allows us to, like, lead better, if that makes sense.
Because absolutely.
The team chemistry is just off the charts this year.
Tell us about what an impact Coach Hovick's made on your life.
Coach Hovick is everything. He's kind of like a big inspiration to me because super similar to, like, his high school career and his playing career was kind of similar to mine. And just the way he is super similar to me, so it's almost like, you know, a older brother or, like, the person who's already gone through your path.
They have such a – it's just a different relationship over there at Central. I think you're going to see – honestly, I think you're going to see special things in the playoffs. I really do. I think they're surrounded by athletes. They have a leader at quarterback. Dominic, what is your Twitter?
DBocci23.
We already have Army, we already have Navy, the United States Merchant Marine Academy, Washington University, St. Louis. Look, you better be a big player on the block if you want to get the attention of this young man. If you're listening, Princeton, Yale, Cornell, Harvard, wake up.
I'll be voting for this guy one day.
You are missing the boat, okay? Dom, thank you so much for joining us. I can't wait to see your continued success. Proud member of the My Recruits platform, one of the first guys I've ever had a chance to work with, and I have been honored. Thank you, Dom.
Thanks, Dom.
Thank you so much for your time.
Hey, Vince, we are at the end. The Varsity Sports Show's up next. What do you got coming on?
Well, not Dominic Bocci, but I got a lot of good stuff coming, and it's going to be a great show. Our talented team is here. Coach, thanks for the opportunity. Don't go anywhere, guys.
We will be back.
AM 1060 KDUS Tempe Phoenix and KSLX HD2 Scottsdale Phoenix.
Coming right up, another fun varsity sports show.
In 2019, the JV Sports Show podcast began with the idea of spotlighting young people in our community. In time, that podcast evolved into radio, television, and live stream, and through that evolution, new ideas have enhanced delivery, giving a stage to students both in front of and behind the microphone in Arizona and beyond. Thank you for supporting the Varsity Sports Show, now the Varsity Media Foundation, a 501c3.